Georgette Norman, director of Troy University Rosa Parks Museum here in Montgomery, Alabama. A museum that pays homage to one of the seminal events of the 20th century, the 382-day Montgomery bus boycott. On your tour at the museum, you get a chance to get key information as to why and how Negroes, as they were called back then, were able to stage this historic event and become part of history yourself. Come with me on a tour of the museum. Your guided tour begins in the orientation room, where you get a glimpse into the segregated South, meet key players of the boycott, begin to understand the roles of organizational structures, interracial partnerships, and the role of women. Now let's move into the bus room. After witnessing Rosa Parks' famous "No" heard round the world and her ultimate arrest, we go to the first mass meeting at Holt Street Baptist Church, where you become a part of the congregation and realize that indeed the boycott had been successful and we are about to embark on a few more days. You meet Reverend Martin Luther King at a very personal moment when he questioned his decision to lead the Montgomery Improvement Association after his life was threatened. When he has his epiphany that says, "Martin, stand up for righteousness and justice." We also meet Martin when he proved that indeed he was a Gandhian, when it was tested and his house was bombed, and he told the crowd, "Lay down your weapons and go home." We learn about national and international support for the boycott and how with 19 station wagons, the Montgomery Improvement Association started a massive transportation system. The Supreme Court of the United States ruled in Browder v. Gale, the case which ended the boycott, that segregation on the buses in Montgomery, Alabama was unconstitutional. And so after 382 days of boycotting, buses were integrated in Montgomery, Alabama. To get the fuller story and experience it for yourself, please visit us and enjoy the event that embarked on 10 of the most profound years in U.S. history, from 1955 to 1965. I'm Georgette Norman, director of Troy University Rosa Parks Museum.